Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that is return on average equity, which is also known as your ROAE. So now this is a part and a parcel of ratio analysis. Let's understand this ratio so that we get some insight regarding what we exactly are talking about here. Return on average equity. This ratio basically helps us to understand how well the shareholder's equity is used to generate the net income. So what is the level of the shareholder's equity which is providing the ROE to used or basically used to generate the net income? Let's understand this with some formulas and examples so that we get some more insight. See, many investor wants to know how much net income you can say is been generated by using the shareholders' equity, right? And that's why we take a net income into account and then divide the whole net profit by the shareholders' equity. So here's the return on the average equity ROAE formula. The formula is something goes like this: it's net income divided by the average shareholders equity. So this is how things are going to go about, right? The example is going to be the next portion of our explanation. I'm going to come back towards the interpretation part of ROAE, because without interpretation any ratio is useless, right? So we just understood how to formulate the formula for ROAE. Now we'll do an example of the same so that we get some insight. Let's take a practical example of return on average equity formula. Let's say there is a company called Big Brothers and Company that has provided you with some following information. The information that has been provided to us is the net income, which is the first and the foremost thing. Let's say it is $45,000. Then you have the beginning shareholders equity. That's the next thing, the beginning shareholders equity, which is $1,35,000, and then you have your ending figure of the shareholders equity, which is $1,65,000. So based on this, find out the return on the average equity. That is our formula, that's what we are supposed to find, which is also known as your ROAE of Big Brothers Limited or the company. Now here, the first we'll calculate the average shareholders equity by simply adding the beginning and the ending figures and then divide by 2. So here's the calculation. The average shareholders equity will go something like this. Your opening, that's your beginning, plus your ending, and this whole divide by 2 will give us the average shareholders equity, which is $1,50,000. We have net income that is available to us, which is $45,000. So I'll just put this below here, net income. So using this ratio, we can now find the ROAE, and we get something like this applying the formula. So to recollect the formula, I'll go back to the previous sheet, which is net income divided by average shareholders equity. So let's take up the net income, 45,000. The average shareholders equity is 1,50,000. So the ratio goes something like this: 45,000 divided by 1,50,000, that's 30%. So this is how the formula has been calculated. Now let's understand this particular formula by correlating it with a real life company. And we are going to take here Colgate as the benchmark. Now I'm going to show you a balance sheet detail of Colgate of 2008 to 2015. The Colgate's return on, this is the balance sheet, the Colgate's returns on average equity has remained healthy in the range of, this is your ROE as you can see. And RO is your net income after the preference shares and minority divided by the common equity shares. So the ROE is remained healthy in the last 7 to 8 years between 2008 to 2013, there has been was around 90%. It was close to 90%. There was a quite bit of movement on an average, you can say, right? Because a couple of numbers were there. Now, in 2014, the return on equity was 126.4%. And in 2015, it jumped significantly to 327.27%. Now, this has happened despite of the 34% decrease in the net income. The decrease in spite of the decrease in the net income, this is the position from 126 to 327. Return on equity jumped significantly because of the decrease in the shareholders' equity in 2015. So shareholders' equity decreased due to the share buyback process. The shareholders' equity has also reduced. So there are two things that happened. The first thing was that the net income in 2015, this has happened because of the decrease in the net income in 2015, and it has reduced. And the shareholders, the shareholders' equity has also been reduced in this particular scenario. Now let's understand the explanation part, the explanation of return on average equity formula. In this ROAE formula, there are two components. The first and the foremost component, we can find that the net income in the income statement of the company. So this you can find from the income statement of the company. That is also known as your P&L, that's a profit and loss. See, net income is the last item. It's completely the last item in the income statement. We calculate the net income by deducting the operating expenses, if any. Remember this. And other unrelated expenses. After that, you receive this. And from the operational revenue and other incomes of the company. Second, however, here, since we are calculating the proportion only on the basis of the shareholders' equity, we shouldn't deduct interest expense in the net income here. Third, since we are not taking debt into account over here in the ratio, it doesn't make sense to include the cost of debt. That is the interest expense in the formula. However, if the company is a whole equity company and there is no debt, then we won't need to consider any such measure. Now the second component of the formula is the average shareholders equity. Now the shareholders equity is important financial statement which we often include under the balance sheet. Second, in shareholders equity, we can include the common shares, you can say the equity, then we include the PSC, that is the preference shares, and dividend, if any. Now, third, to find out the average of the shareholders equity, we need to consider both the beginning figure as well as the ending figure of the shareholders equity. And once we have the two figures, we'll just use the simple average to find out the average shareholders equity. However, we need to refine the process, and if there are more equity transactions during the period, then it's better to use the weighted average method to find the average.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.